So the Griffin study is a randomized phase 2 study evaluating incorporating the CD38 antibody daratumumab into the lenalidomide bortezomib dexamethasone or RVD backbone in newly diagnosed transplant eligible multiple myeloma patients. So patients on the standard of care arm receive 4 cycles of RVD induction therapy followed by transplant, 2 cycles of post-transplant RVD consolidation, and then lenalidomide maintenance therapy. In the daratumumab arm, they receive the exact same platform, but daratumumab is provided weekly during the induction period. They receive it on day 1 of each consolidation cycle, and then they receive it once every 4 weeks for 2 years in maintenance. Patients are encouraged to remain on lenalidomide maintenance therapy until disease progression. We know that these patients are going to do very well in the long term, so we wanted a primary endpoint with an early readout assessing depth of response differences between the two regimens. So we chose stringent complete response by the end of consolidation as our primary endpoint. We know that minimal residual disease testing is a very powerful tool for assessing depth of response in multiple myeloma, so that was an important secondary endpoint. And we looked at other clinical efficacy parameters as well as safety. We had reported previously in the IMW meeting back in September that we had achieved our primary endpoint of improvement in stringent complete response. So at that time, what we had showed is that by the end of consolidation, the stringent complete response rate was 42.4% in the daratumumab arm, and it was 32% in the control arm. At ASH, we have a median follow-up now of 22.1 months. I'm happy to report that the stringent complete responses continue to improve. So we're at 63% in the daratumumab arm, and we're at 45% in the control arm, and this is highly statistically significant. When you look at MRD testing, MRD negativity at 10 to the minus 5 using an NGS technique is approximately 50% for those in the DARA arm, and it's 20% in those in the control arm. And we're going to be reporting progression-free and overall survival, at least preliminary progression-free and overall survival. And at 2 years, progression-free survival in the daratumumab arm is a very impressive 96%. And it's also very good in the control arm as well. It's approximately 90%. So we're going to need to monitor these patients over time to see if we begin to see any meaningful differences in progression-free survival over time.